just kind of thinking, thinking about why I did this walk and everything I've seen on this walk and how I can't believe it's nearly over. And yeah, I don't know, it's just hard. It's hard to believe that I'm nearly finished. I keep thinking, what if I didn't stop at John O'Groats? What if I went beyond John O'Groats? There's two other islands above England and Scotland, the Orkney Islands and the Shetland Islands. What if I walked those as well?
If you're going to try, go all the way. Otherwise, don't even start. If you're going to try, go all the way. This could mean losing girlfriends, wives, relatives, jobs, and maybe your mind. Go all the way. It could mean not eating for 3 or 4 days. It could mean freezing on a park bench. It could mean jail. It could mean derision, mockery, isolation. Isolation is the gift. All the others are a test of your endurance, of how much you really want to do it. And you'll do it. Despite rejection and the worst odds, and it will be better than anything else you can imagine. If you're going to try, go all the way. There is no other feeling like that. You will be alone with the gods, and the nights will flame with fire. Do it. Do it. Do it. Do it. All the way. All the way. You will ride life straight to perfect laughter. It's the only good fight there is.
The journey isn't over yet. Good fucking God, what have I done? I'm on Orkney. I just made it onto Orkney now. And I have 20 miles to walk. Unfortunately, I just found out that the next ferry in Kirkwall leaves at midnight tonight. And there's not another one until Tuesday. I can't do because I have a flight on the 12th to take me to Glasgow, so I have until then to walk Shetland and Orkney, which leaves me with 20 miles to walk in about 5 hours, and it's all on A roads. I won't be able to do anything cool on Orkney, unfortunately, which really sucks. But what the hell? I'm like on a completely different island now. Welcome to Orkney. And I literally have to race through this entire island as quickly as I can. I don't have a lot of time. I've literally got to get to the next ferry in about 5 hours, and it's 20 miles. So it really sucks because this place is so full of history and stuff, and I'm not gonna get to see any of it. I'm just gonna see roads. You know, and I'm gonna see roads blurred past me because I have to walk so bloody fast. But hopefully Shetland will be a little bit nicer, a little bit more laid back. for now I've just got to walk and walk and walk as fast as I can. I don't like rushing. I liked the laid back Lejog. Here we go, Kirkwall. This is where I'm headed for. Kirkwall. So I've got to go. I've got to go as fast as I can. Ooh, these cows are a bit feisty. Alright, let's go as fast as we can, shall we? These cows are literally just following me. There we go. Okay, so new update. Someone has tried to stop to give me a lift. So I asked them to take Big Bertha as far as they could. So they're taking her to St. Margaret's Hope, which means I can run for about 5-6 miles. Oh, save me a ton of time, these fucking cows. They're everywhere and they all just get really excited. So I've got to run for about 5 miles now. Try and catch the fucking ferry. Boy, so that gentleman just there in the background, he's actually taken my bag all the way to Kirkwall. He just bought me a Coke at that cafe, and it gives me the chance to run the entire thing. I have 17 miles to run now, and all I've eaten is a brownie, a pizza, and some rice. So, this is gonna be a day to fucking remember. So I hope I can get this fucking ferry, because I'll be really upset if I get there and I can't. So, oh yes! Come on then! I've got 17 miles, I have to fucking run it all. About 2 miles away from the city now, or town, or whatever you want to call it. I can see lights way away in the distance. I've just got to follow it now, thank God. Oh my God, I've just literally made it to the place I was going to rendezvous with Lawrence and his lovely wife at the Highland Park Distillery, which again, I'm bloody heartbroken I can't go to, because I do love good Highland Park. My phone's gonna die soon, but I'm just gonna call them now and get my bag and then hopefully get on the ferry ASAP. I need some food, I'm so hungry. So that's priority number one, I think. This is Lawrence, and this is the man and his wife actually saved the day. I would never have made it to this ferry if it wasn't for him and his wife. And they've just donated to the MS Society as well, which was lovely. And they made me some sandwiches.
Yeah.
So it's absolutely amazing.
Thank you.
Yeah, I do. I definitely need it. Thank you, mate. Thank you very much. I appreciate that. Cheers.
I made it onto the ferry with literally 5 minutes to spare. I was extremely lucky to make it. By some miracle, I had ran 23 miles in 6 hours. But I had now completed Orkney, and only Shetland was ahead.
I just ran 23 miles and smashed out the Orkneys on the same day that I also finished Lejog. I deserve this fucking beer. So on the ferry now, like, there's the bar. The most important part. And yeah, I've got 8 hours on the sea to Shetland now. Okay, so there's my ferry. That's what I just come off of. And now I'm in Shetland. I'm actually a little bit too far north at the moment to start my walk. I've got to get all the way down to Sumburgh, where at the moment I'm in Lerwick. So the plan is to go and find somewhere I can get a coffee, use their internet, and try and find a way down to Sumburgh. I've got to do that twice. I've got to take that journey twice now. Once to get to the bottom, and then another time so I can get my flight later on. So, I don't know. But at the moment, this place looks pretty cool. I like it so far. Just a case of trying to navigate around it. So I've more or less spent a whole day in Kirkwall, just pretty much having a rest day, not doing a hell of a lot. And now I'm heading towards the Viking bus station to look at getting a bus down to Sumburgh, which is where the start of my walk is. Look at all those boats. Look at all those boats. There they are. Very cool. I actually quite enjoy Shetland so far. Well, I like Kirkwall anyway.
I took an hour bus down to Sumburgh Head, where I camped for the night. The next morning was absolutely freezing, and I woke up with frost on my bivvy.
Good morning. I am in the freezing cold south of Shetland in Sumburgh. That's the Sumburgh Hotel right there. I cheekily camped in the field right next to it, but to be honest with you, I didn't even get here until midnight. So I was so cold last night. I am wearing absolutely everything. I even stole a blanket from the ferry to get here, and I'm still freezing cold, and my bivvy's also frozen.
I had some breakfast at the hotel behind me before I went and started my walk from the start of Sumburgh Head.
Into the night, underneath the stars, in our glass house we sat for hours and hours. You were the moon, and I was the sea. That night, it was just you and me. You shone your light upon me, your reflection warmed my heart. That night, it was just you and me. All those nights we've had that weren't like this seem such a waste. Yeah. scented ambience divine. We drank each other's words more than we drank wine. That night it was just you and me. Filled my cup till it overflowed with words pleasing to my ears. Night, it was just you and me. All those nights we've had that weren't like this seem such a...
I just found a bus stop. Just a random bus stop. With a really comfy seat in it. Such a nice thought this is. Into the night now, I reckon. So that's shit, but it's fine. We can do this. We're gonna do this. Met an actual real life, well, a couple of real life treasure hunters there. Well, they've got their little metal detectors, and they're just going over this field, which this is the field I've decided I'm going to sleep in tonight. One thing I've definitely noticed about Shetland is there's absolutely no trees anywhere. I'm thinking about it now. I don't think I've seen a tree all day, which is really weird. Like, I've been told that it's not covered, but like, this is really not covered, which is kind of funny. But at the same time, I definitely won't be getting any fires for the entire time that I'm here if it's going to be like this the whole time. Well, I'm all set up. Just making my food now. And I have to say, I really wish I had a hot chocolate right now, because it's so cold. And it definitely feels like September now. So I'm gonna put my jumper on in a little bit, hopefully then I'll feel the benefit. But other than that, I'm just hoping I don't run out of gas. That's the only thing. I should have enough. But if it gets slightly windy, then I might not. So it's just down to luck now, I guess. So, but right now I really need a nice cup of coffee and some super noodles. It's a cold one this morning. Again. Well, it's not as cold as last time. Well, yesterday. But it was definitely... it's definitely chilly. Today I'm heading for a place called Vaux, which is 25 miles away, because I got to make up the miles that I didn't make yesterday. So that's where I've come from, that little field over there. And I'm heading into a really long stretch of road that's apparently all a place called Cummingborough. So I'm really hoping I'll find some kind of cafe or shop, because my phone is not charged. So that's not a good thing at all. But the other thing as well is I could really do with a coffee. I skipped breakfast this morning. It was too windy to get my stove going, because it's a cheap piece of crap. And so that's what I'm going to do now. So I've just been lucky enough, as I was walking up the road, a guy standing outside his house just asked me what I was doing while I was hiking, and I told him what I'd been doing. And he was really nice enough to offer me a shower and gave me some breakfast and let me charge my phone. So my phone's okay now. I couldn't record any of it because my phone pretty much was dead by the time I walked into his house. But that was really good of him, actually. So I'm pretty much set for the day now. I've eaten, I've got a shower, and now I've got my phone sorted. So now bring on those 25 miles. I was recommended by the guy who gave me a shower earlier to come to this location here alongside the road and kind of go up this little path a little bit. And right here, I can find some peat berries. Which is the ancient capital of the Shetlands, which is really cool. And I'm just going to try and find somewhere to get something to eat or something. Not too fancy, I haven't got that much time, but it's absolutely stunning here. It's beautiful. It's a bit windy today, but other than that, it's actually really nice here so far. We've got a castle way, way, way off over there. And, there's the sea, and yeah, it's just. It's very beautiful, I like it. After a quick sandwich, a quick pint, I enjoy Scalloway. The lovely lady at Scalloway Hotel donated £30 to the MS Society, which was really nice of her. I appreciated that. And now I've got to get back on the road. I've got a long, long way to go and it's getting late already, so I'm definitely not going to make Vaux tonight. But that's okay, I'm not going to kill myself trying to get there. I'm just gonna walk as far as I can until it gets dark and then just continue tomorrow. As much as I'm really loving Shetland, and I really do like Shetland a lot, walking on the A roads is so boring and annoying, especially since I've just done like every trail in England and Scotland that's like famous anyway. And now I'm just walking on this boring, long, straight fucking A road, and it's destroying my feet as well. Keep taking breaks like every 20 minutes just because I don't want to walk. It's getting annoying. I've still got like 9 miles to do and it's getting dark. I think I'm going to be walking right into the evening tonight. That's if I even find a place to camp. Even the birds commit suicide around here. I was just walking along and look at that. How creepy is that? Just a bunch of gnomes just hanging out. It just keeps on going. It just goes on forever. When will it end?
It didn't take me very long to just finally give up today and find myself a place to camp.
So last night I decided to pack up because I had nowhere else to go, so I ended up sleeping right next to the road, which is dodgy enough as it is. And I woke up and it's absolutely pissing with rain. Luckily my setup actually has kept the rain off of me. But my phone's on like 3%. And my last charging pack is in my bag. Probably getting wet right now out there. So it's like 7:45. and I'm waiting for the rain to stop. It's really annoying.
So I more or less camped here last night, right next to the road. Not the safest place. My normal rule would be don't ever camp next to a road, because this is a fast road, this is a 50 mile an hour road, so if someone decides to drink drive or something like that and come straight off the road, I could have been killed. But honestly, there really wasn't much else to go. That's all moors and stuff, that's all moors and hills. Can't really do much about it. But I lived, started raining, everything is wet, so it's not a great start to the morning. But I know that there's a pub in Vaux, about 3 miles away. I'm hoping to maybe go in there and charge my phone, have something to eat, something to drink, and then I'll continue on. And hopefully I'll be on Yell today. I should be able to get there. There's about 10 miles to the ferry, then the ferry takes about 10 minutes, and then I can get onto Yell, walk as far as I can, and then, to be honest with you, by tomorrow I should be on score, in score. There's no excuse why not. So those heather berries, or whatever they're called, peat berries, heather berries, last night at my bivvy. They were really nice actually, they taste like apples, so that was pleasant. I wanted to make a tea out of them, but it was just too windy to use my stove, which is another thing that's really annoying me at the moment, is if I get to camp and I know it's windy, I know that I'm not really going to get much dinner, because my camp, my stove is so shit. So I think next expedition I'm really going to try and sort my equipment out a bit better, because it's getting annoying. This far, I mean, it's cool that they've lasted this far. This is nearly, I think I'm on 1,250 miles. But, I don't know, it just starts to grind on your morale eventually. Especially when you're in such a remote area and you have to rely on your equipment and yourself and your own skills. I can't even make a fire. There's no trees or anything like that. It's just barren as fuck. There's just this one road that goes straight through and I've got to follow it. I'm pretty sure these are the first trees I've actually seen on Shetland. I don't think I'd have been able to camp in there. It looks very thick, very artificial. I think they're probably just... these are probably the only trees on Shetland. But yeah, that's really weird to think. That is the first trees I've seen in like 2 days. Found this like valley wall. I'm walking through this valley on the road, and there's so many like tiny little buildings, like just literally on the hill. There's one there, there's one way up there, just on the hill. I love it, it's so cool. Like, this is such a remote and tiny, like, there would never be a shop around here. You probably have to drive for like 5 miles even just to get to a little corner shop. But these guys have decided they want to live in the hills. Like, it's just a big bowl, you know, like a big valley. Yesterday I walked and I saw a bunch of gnomes, which is creepy, and now, this time I've seen some trolls. around the corner and I can see the next island. It's just over there. I can see the ferry and everything. And that's the island of Yell. That's where I'm heading to now. So I just spent probably about an hour and a half chilling at the ferry place, and the ladies in this convenience store were really nice, let me charge my phone, had a cup of coffee with them, and yeah, so now I'm heading off to Gutcha, where I need to get the next ferry to Unst. Definitely not going to get there tonight. I've got to do maybe another 5 more miles, camp up, and then head out of this little island to the next island. Enjoying the sunset right now.
Last night it was really windy and I was actually worried at one point my tarp was going to come flying off, but it didn't. It looks like it's still attached, so that's good. And then this morning it started raining just as I woke up. Like, my alarm went, kind of opened my eyes, nothing, and then that sound. But like, a lot heavier, so I decided to just go back to sleep in hopes it would just stop after a while. And it's starting to, it sounds like it's starting to kind of go down now.
So it's kind of funny that I went to bed with really nice weather and I've woken up and it's absolutely, I don't know how to describe it, it's foggy and really windy and also keeps like bursting out into rain and stuff, and it's weird. Because I remember leaving this place beautiful and now it just looks like something out of a horror movie. whatever, I'm just going to try and get dressed and go. Well, that wasn't particularly fun trying to pack up that in this wind, but I'm on the road now. It's really windy today, like, and the wind is going against me, so I have to push against that. But there is a diner about 5 miles away from here that I'm headed for, and I need a coffee badly. So that's what I'm headed for now. It's still quite foggy. Not as bad as it was when I first got up, but it does make the place look completely different. Yeah. This wind is pretty strong now. Reminds me of being up in the West Highlands, actually. Very peaty and very boggy. There's not a lot to see. Yeah.
The next 5 miles was some of the hardest that I'd faced in Shetland. I had to contend with cutting wind and horizontal rain, but eventually I would get to a nice cafe near the top of the hill where I would rest for a little while.
So I just spent a few hours in LJ's diner just to charge my phone, have something to eat and chill out a bit. And as soon as I leave, it's about to storm. The irony is, it was like beautiful sunshine outside while I was sat inside. And then this happens. So if it starts raining by the time I get to the top of this hill, I'm just going to go to the northernmost pub and have myself a pint before I head off into the horrible storm. So I have about 10 miles to walk until I get to the ferry, and then I want to walk another 5 miles after that, just so I'm ready to take on the last little bit. So it should be good. Just as my luck would go, the pub in Yell is closed. There is no pub on Yell. That's just silly, isn't it? So I won't be sitting inside out of this storm. I could just go back to the cafe, but to be honest with you, I'd rather just get going now. I'm on my way back down to the main road and then on to the ferry. Well, I think I've either outrun the storm or I've just been lucky and it's not happened. But I didn't get wet. And I'm about 6.5 miles away from it now, which is really, really good. But outrunning the storm, it's just started raining. Which isn't good because I've got an hour walk until I get to the ferry. Thing I've definitely noticed about Shetland is absolutely rife with just broken down buildings. They're just buildings that aren't used anymore, that haven't really been cleaned up or whatever. God knows how old they are. They could be extremely old, or they could just be like fairly recent in the last century or something. treasure here. This is a Viking longhouse. One long straight road in the wind to get to Baltasound, which is where I'm headed for tonight. I want to stop there, hopefully resupply, because I'm very much running low. There's just not a lot to not a lot of shops or anything around here really. And then I'll take on the last 7 miles tomorrow morning. Found this little cairn here. Like, I'm not aware that there's any trail at all, but I'll, in the spirit of hoping there is one day a trail in Shetland, I'll add a stone to the cairn. That's cool. I hope there'll be nice if there was a trail. Walking on the road is horrible, absolutely horrific. I hate it. But someone tells me these are just animal tracks. And I don't want to get myself lost because I don't even have a map. So I'm just going to stick to the road, get to Baltasound, hopefully find some beer. But I hope one day they do actually open an actual trail. It'd be really cool to link up Land's End to John O'Groats and all the way up to Score just by footpaths. That would be really cool. But maybe I'm wrong, and maybe there is a footpath and I'm just not aware of it. Who knows? Well, that sounded disrespectful, and I really don't mean it as disrespectful, but sometimes walking through this on this long ass road that's completely straight between hills with absolutely nothing on them but brown moss, it does kind of feel like I'm walking through like a post-apocalyptic kind of land. Back to weird shit again. What? It's weirder. I don't even know. It's even a big smiley face in the back. I have no idea what that's all about. I'm sure there's got to be an explanation though. Just took a break just to have the last of my food, which I just realized I have nothing left, and I had a little look on Google Maps to see what was going to be open in Baltasound, and nothing's going to be open in Baltasound. There's one thing that's open, and that's Baltasound Hotel that has a restaurant that's only open till 8 o'clock. So I just gave them a call to see if they could give me something to take away, and I just explained I'm doing it for charity and all that sort of stuff, and she was going to be really kind enough to actually give me something, which is so sweet of her. So she just said, come in when you can and we'll sort you out with some food. I'm like, no way! So yeah, that's really, really cool. So at least I've got somewhere to go and get some food tonight. Although I have no faith in the weather today. It looks like it's just going to be horrible, but at least I'm going to have something to eat.
Manager of the Baltasound Hotel was kind enough to give me a bunch of sandwiches and even a beer to help me along my way. After that, I headed back to the little town church where I decided to stay for the night. last night was comfy-ish, because this wasn't too bad. Although there's two of those, they kept falling apart, I kept falling between them. It was fairly warm, so it wasn't too bad. It didn't rain last night, so it was completely pointless to be sleeping inside, really. Except I didn't have to sort out my scent and stuff. Other than that, was it right? Just like sleeping in every other church. So I was so beyond paranoid of anyone walking in. I didn't care if anyone walked in. I was just like, you know what, I'm going to sleep, I don't care. And if anyone did walk in, I'd just be like, hey. That's how beyond it, I don't care anymore. So it's about 7:15 in the morning, but the shop doesn't open till 9. I just can't sleep anymore. I'm just not comfortable. So I'm going to slowly get up. That's more or less it, really. I'm going to try and dry my stuff out today. And most importantly, I've got to get to the most northerly point of the UK.
So I found out there's a cafe just down there with a shop and everything like that. So I'm just gonna leave my tarps over there to dry. I've left my bag inside the church. Grab me postcards and I'm gonna just go down to see if the cafe will open. And I'm just gonna sit in there, have a cup of tea because I really want one. Spent a lot more time in the cafe than I expected. It's about nearly 12 o'clock, but the start of the trail to the top of Hermaness is only about 5 miles away, so that's not so bad. So I'm gonna head up there now. So if my map is correct, I should be coming right up to a thing called Bobby's Bus Shelter, which I actually found on YouTube one time. So I'm gonna go have a little look at that, because that's to me kind of a bit of a famous thing. People who try to walk through Shetland come to die. Huge longboat, Viking longboat, like a replica, I believe. One person told me that they built this so they could try and sail across the sea like the Vikings did. Something to do with it failing, I can't remember now. But they've also got a longhouse here as well, which is really, really, really cool. We'll be right back. Well, that was certainly a privilege and an experience to explore a proper replica, full-size replica of a Viking longboat.
After my exploration of the Viking longboat, it finally dawned on me that I was a mile and a half away from the last trail to the end of the world.
Not far now, about a mile and a half, probably a little bit less than the start of the trail of Hermaness. So that's really, it's quite weird, and I'm completely alone. Which I guess is nice, it's quite peaceful. Down there, that's the big wide open ocean. You go that way, you hit Norway, and then I'm also about to come up to a lock. That lock there is called Cliff Lock, and yeah, it's a pretty big lock. I don't know if it's the most northerly lock or not, but it's a pretty big lock. Yeah, very, very close to the car park now, where I then start on the trail. So I've made it to Hermaness car park, and there's one last trail left to do until I get to the absolute most northerly point of the UK. Let's do this. coming off the end of the pier.
Let me see the end. Let me see the end. Ah!
Take this bag off.
Sorry, Bertha, but that's where you get off.
Look at those cliffs. Yes! As far north as you could possibly go in the UK, and I walked all the way here. Oh, jeez, I'm really, really emotional. It's nearly taken me 4 months to get here.
If you ever want to do something, if you ever want to do anything in this world, and you think it's too hard, just remember the boy who walked 1,000 miles and beyond after passing. packing too much stuff, nearly falling from cliffs after losing his credit card, losing sleep, and almost losing his mind. He went cold, wet, hungry, tired, afraid, in pain, and often lonely. But he made it. Despite all the odds, he made it to the edge of the world. He walked 1,000 miles and beyond.
Come, the march of Sumburgh